Hi guys, welcome back to ASA Technical. If you ever found yourself in a situation where you encountered a blue screen, experienced a Windows crash, or lost valuable data on various websites, you might have suspected a virus or malware infestation, or even feared a potential hacking incident. In such instances, there's a valuable but often overlooked solution called System Restore. System Restore is a tool that comes with your system, and surprisingly many people don't take advantage of its capabilities. Today, I want to emphasize its significance in a brief video. This tool allows you to create System Restore Point in seconds. Imagine creating a System Restore Point today, and if you encounter any issues in next few days, you can revert your system to the state it was in when the System Restore Point was created. Essentially, System Restore acts as a safeguard against unforeseen problems. If you suspect your computer has been compromised or want to rescue your data from the potential hacking or malware threats, System Restore is highly recommended. In this video, I will guide you through the simple process of creating Restore Point. This proactive step can save you from future headaches. So, don't miss the chance to secure your system. Watch the video now and take a moment to create a crucial Restore Point. It's a short but invaluable investment in the health of your computer. I'm going to explain everything to you quickly here. And guys, before starting, please like and subscribe the video so that I know if you are finding my content useful. And if you want a video on any topic on any content, then must tell me in the comment section. So let's start without any delay. Search for Create a Restore Point in the Windows search bar and then click on Open. Now choose the system drive and click on Configure. Select Turn on System Protection and set up the max usage of the disk space. We recommend setting the disk space usage between 5 to 10%. Then select OK. This action will enable the System Restore Point. Note that the max usage will be persisted as the disk space you designated and will be utilized for System Restore Point. As space becomes limited, older restore point will be automatically removed to create space for new ones. Now select a drive that have System Protection turned on and then click on Create. Type a description to help you identify the restore point and then click on Create. Okay, as you can see, the restore point was created successfully. And now click on Close. Now here, I'll be showing you by restore our computer from a restore point. Now search for Create Restore Point in the Windows search bar. Then click on Open. Select System Restore and click on Next. Select the restore point that you want to use in the list of results. And then select Scan for Affected Programs. A list of items slated for deletion upon restoring to this point will be displayed. If you are comfortable with the deletions, proceed by selecting Close to advance to the next step. In case the desired restore point is not visible, opt for the Show More Restore Point checkbox to unveil additional options. If in the event that the current restore point does not align with your needs, then return to the previous step and select an alternative restore point. Now select Next. Now confirm your system information is correct or not. Then select Finish. Now select Yes to start the restoring system from the restore point, and then your computer will ask for restore. Note, this might take some time to restore your system from the restore point. And make sure that AC power supply is connected during the restore process. And please do not force to shut down to prevent any issues. After the computer restarts, System Restore is completed. Now simply click on Close. Once Alternatively, you can use advanced startup settings to access the system restore feature to recover the system if the computer does not start correctly. To use system restore through advanced startup environment, use these tips. Start your computer. As soon as the Windows logo appears, press the power button to interrupt the boot process. Repeat these steps 3 to 4 times or until the device boots into the recovery environment. Click on Advanced Option button. Alright, once you are in the Windows recovery environment, you can use these steps to revert your system changes with System Restore. If you can't access the recovery environment, you can try to boot from the Windows Installation Media. If you don't have a Windows Installation Media, then here's a certain tutorial for you. Okay, once you are in the Windows Setup page, click on Next button. Click on Repair Your Computer button from the bottom left corner. To undo the system changes on Windows 11 or Windows 10 through the Advanced Startup Environment, you can use these steps. Click Troubleshoot. Click on System Restore. Select the Windows account and confirm the account password if prompted. Now click on Next. Now select the restore point to fix the problem with your device. Click on Next. Click the Scan for Affected Programs button to confirm the apps that will be removed because they were added after the creating restore point. Now finally click on Finish. Now keep patience until the system restore process is completed. Once you complete the steps, the restore point will apply to undo system changes that may be causing problem, including those preventing the computer from starting correctly. System restore is the only feature to recover the device from the configuration problems quickly. And note, this is not a feature to replace a backup solution or an option to reset the computer to the factory default settings. However, you can check out our channel. There's available some certain blue screen of death related solutions by using system restore point. So, I hope this guide was helpful for you. If you have any question or any advanced guide, then please let us know. Please like, comment and share. We need your support. And guys, please don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.